Welcome to the passages of blood and filtrate in urine formation. This video is to clarify where blood travels and where the filtrate is found when discussing urine formation. Now, follow the red moving circle on the screen. This circle represents blood. Blood is pumped out of the heart and travels through the aorta before reaching the renal artery and entering the kidney. It then travels into the afferent arteriole, into the glomerulus, that first knot of capillaries, then the efferent arteriole, and then into the peritubular capillary network. Note that blood never enters any tubules of the nephron. Although substances will move from the blood to the tubule, be reabsorbed and move back into the blood from the tubule, or are actively secreted out of the blood and into the tubule, blood itself never travels into the nephron. Note as well that with this diagram, we only see one nephron and its associated vessels. There are over a million nephrons in each kidney, which means that there will be over a million associated blood vessels. The blood then travels out of the renal vein and into the inferior vena cava, going back to the heart. Now let's look at the filtrate. Here we can see the filtrate traveling through the tubules of the nephron. It started off in the glomerular capsule, that C-shaped, backwards C-shaped tubule, followed by the proximal convoluted tubule, the loop of the nephron, which we can see going down and up, then into the distal convoluted tubule, and eventually flowing into the collecting duct. The urine will then pass out of the renal pelvis and into the ureters. From the ureters, the urine will be transported into the urinary bladder, where it will be temporarily stored for a time before passing out of the urethra.